There are tons of the STEAM educational kits you can find from the market nowadays, but how do you identify the best one among them? Hey, this is Coach Chris. In this video, I'm going to share with you what are the criteria of a good STEAM educational kit. So before we talk about the criteria, let me introduce some of the popular STEAM educational kits we can find from the market nowadays. The first one is the Arduino, which is my favorite. And also, you can find this Middle Uno from the market, which is developed by the Citron Malaysia, one of our local company. And also, Microbit, which is developed by the BBC from UK. We also can find some popular robotic kits like Lego, Vex, and MacBlox, and also other educational kits that are related to STEAM in the market nowadays. So talk about the first criteria of the STEAM educational kits is the building capability. Now all of the STEAM educational kits build requires the student to DIY themselves, which means do it yourself. Unlike toys that come in a ready-made form, STEAM educational kits will require the student to assemble part by themselves. But another important part of this building capability is the flexibility. Well, of course, every STEAM educational kit will come with a user manual and instructions on how to construct the default design. But a good STEAM educational kit will allow the students to make up different designs according to their ideas and creativity by using the same kits. So this building capability part basically trains up the students in terms of science, engineering, and arts as well. So another criteria of a good STEAM educational kit is the programming capability. Well, the programming capability allows the student to make use of the same design but carries out different kinds of tasks or actions. And this is also very important in training the algorithm of the students. And what is meant by the algorithm is actually a sequence of small actions that need to perform to fulfill a task. So what's worth to take note while choosing the STEAM educational kits is the programming language that used in that kits. Because basically now we have two kinds of programming language, which is one we call it as a text-based programming language. For example, C programming, Java programming, Python programming, and so on. Another programming language is known as the graphical programming. For example, Scratch, MBlock, and Microbit as well. They are using predefined blocks, and what the students need to do is just link the blocks by themselves. So this kind of programming language is simple and easier to be understood and catch up by the students in order to learn, unlike the text-based programming, which needs everything to be correct. For example, a single syntax will cause an error for the entire program. So graphical programming eliminates this kind of limitations, thus every kid can learn programming from the younger age. So these two are the important criteria in choosing a good STEAM educational kit, and I hope it is useful for the students who wanted to start in these STEAM learning educations. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.